الله وبركاته. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، good morning to my respected principal Hazrat Maulana Habib Qasim Sahab and my respected sir and all colleagues. I would like to say thank you to give me such a great opportunity to speak something on our republic day. My name is Muhammad Tawfiq Sheikh. I read in class 7. Today we all are here to celebrate 69th Republic Day of our nation. This is a great and auspicious occasion for all of us. We should celebrate the Republic Day of India on 26th of January as the Constitution of India came into force as this day. We are regularly celebrating the Republic Day of India since 1950 on 26th of January. In 1950, India Constitution came into force. India is a democratic country where people is authorized to elect its leaders to lead the country. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was our first president of India since we got independence from the British. Only in 1947, our country had developed a lot among the powerful countries. Together with some brave acts also arise such inequality, poverty, unemployment, corruption, illiteracy, etc. We need to take a place today for solving such problems in our country to make our country the best country of the world. Thanks.
Walaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulil kareem. Amma ba'd. Mohtaram buzurgo aur dosto. جنگ آزادی اور مسلمان ہندوستان کی آزادی تاریخ کا ایک اہم حصہ ہے. اہم اس لیے کیونکہ کہ اس آزادی کو پانے کے لیے لاکھوں ہندوستانیوں نے اپنی جانوں کی قربانی دی اور اپنے سروں کی قیمت پر انگریزوں کی ظالمانہ حکومت کو اکھاڑ پھینکا. آزادی کی اس جنگ میں ہندو اور مسلمان شریک تھے, لیکن افسوس کی بات یہ ہے کہ آج ہندوستان کی ہسٹری میں صرف دو چار مسلمانوں کے نام ملتے ہیں. یہ ایک سازش ہے جس کے تحت ہندوستان کی آزادی کے شہید مسلمانوں کو ہندوستان کی ہسٹری سے اپنے حساب سے بدلنا شروع کیا گیا اور مسلمان ہندوستان کے اور مسلمان اس جنگ ہندو کو مظلوم اور مسلمانوں کو ظالم دکھایا گیا. یہاں تک کہ جنگ آزادی میں شریک مسلمانوں کے نام بھی ہٹا دیے گئے. یہ اس کا نتیجہ یہ ہوا کہ مسلم جنریشن جو 1947 کے بعد 50 سال پیچھے چلی گئی تھی احساس کمزوری کا شکار ہو گئے اور اپنے آپ کو دوسرے درجے کا ناگرک سمجھنے لگے. وآخر دعوانا الحمدللہ رب العالمین.
السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ.
Assalamu alaikum to all. My name is Rehan. I read in Arabic class 4. As we all know, we have gathered here on a very special occasion of our nation called as Republic Day of India. I would like to narrate a Republic Day speech in front of you. First of all, I would like to say a lot of thanks to my class teacher, as just because of her, I had got such a wonderful opportunity in my junior school to come on this stage and speak something about my beloved country on this great occasion of Republic Day. India is a self-governing country since 15th of August 1947. India got independence from the British rule on 15th of August 1947, which we celebrate as Independence Day. However, on 26th of May, we celebrate as Republic Day. The Constitution of India came into force on 26th of May. So we celebrate this day as Republic Day every year. This year in 2018, we celebrate the 69th Republic Day of India. Republic means the supreme power of a people living in a country, and only public has elected representatives as political leaders to lead the country in the right direction. So India is a Republican country. We elect the Republican leaders as president, prime minister, etc. Our great Indian freedom fighters have struggled a lot with the Purna Swaraja in India. They did so that the future generation may lie without struggle and let country ahead. Some of our great Indian Muslim leaders and freedom fighters are Hazrat Mufti Hifazullah Dahlavi, Mufti Muhammad Naeem Mujlanvi, Hazrat Maulana Hindu Rahman Siyarvi, Hazrat Maulana Ubaidullah Singh, etc. They fought continuous struggle against the British to make India a free country. We can never forget their sacrifices towards our country. We should remember them on such great occasion and salute them.
It has just possible because of them that we can think of our own mind and live freely in our nation without anyone's force. Our first president was Dr. Rajendra Prasad, who said that we find the whole of this vast land brought together under the jurisdiction of the Constitution. Of the Constitution and one union, which takes our responsibility for the welfare of 320 men and women in Haiti. Ashamed to say that still we are fighting with crime, corruption, and violence in the form of terrorist rape, theft, fraud, strikes, etc. in our country. Again, there is a need to get together under to save our country from such slavery as it is pulling our nation back from going to its mainstream of development and progress. We should be aware of social issues like poverty, employment, literacy, global warming, inequality, in order to solve them to go ahead. Dr. Abdul Kalam has said that if a country is to be corruption free and become a nation of beautiful minds, I strongly feel there are three key societal members. They are which can make a difference. They are the father, the mother, and the teacher. As a citizen of the country, we should think seriously about it and do all possible. Of course, we need our nation. Thank you.